Since this March, I have worked more events than in 2018 and 19 combined, without even leaving my house. And in this video, I wanted to explain to you how you can start making money by doing virtual events. I will explain to you all details of how to do them and what you need to get started. So no matter what skills you have, if you want to start making virtual events, this video is for you. But before we start, can you guys please hit the like button? All right, what is virtual event? It's pretty much just like regular physical location-based event, but it's happening online. Now with Zoom, everything feels like you're located right next to each other, but actually people who are teach are located thousands of miles away from this studio. You can be offering your services to the weddings, product launch, customer appreciation event, even be part of the global conference where more than 1,000 people are attending. Yep, that happened to me. And all this pretty much using your only laptop and internet connection. Well, and your particular skill, of course. In my case, I teach how to make bar quality cocktails right on your kitchen using minimum bar tools and quality ingredients. It's pretty similar to my 2020 cocktail concept that I do on my main channel, which I'm pretty sure you guys came from, right? But in this case, it's a lot more interactive and entertaining. Before you start promoting your services, here are a few things that need to be taken care of. First is the setup. It doesn't have to be fancy like my studio. It actually could be done in the kitchen or living room, and it will look very real since most of your viewers will be trying to make cocktails also on the kitchen. But what is important is to have a proper light. Since I offer my services to a worldwide audience, sometimes it could be 8 a.m. or 9 p.m. for me, so you don't want to rely only on the daylight. And probably even more important than the light is fast internet connection. If you have slow internet or there's a chance to lose connection, it might ruin the entire experience and most likely you won't be working with that client or agency ever again. It actually happened to me once in the middle of the event, and I can't even describe how stressful I was when there were like 100 people were following my steps and then I disappeared. Well, what I did instead of taking my chances and connect to Wi-Fi again, I switched to my 5G on the phone, finished the event, and threw away my modem. Next on your checklist should be a camera. I use this laptop, and if you have proper light, this little camera should work good. But to improve quality is always a good idea, so you can download an app called Filmic Pro and connect it using this adapter to broadcast through iPhone or any other phone. I think this is just the best way. Next is sound. If you are not sitting directly in front of your laptop camera and like me, have a few feet away, there might be an echo and poor quality sound. I recommend to use Rode mic, or even better, the wireless Rode mic like this one. It has a perfect sound quality. If you guys are interested to get one, I will leave a link in the description for you, so check it out. And the last thing on your checklist, to put all necessary ingredients, tools, notes right in front of you. I always put extra so I don't need to walk around and look for something while 50 people are excited and have to wait for you. This setup will help your event to go smooth and very dynamic. Now, since you have everything ready and set, it's also important to rehearse your routine and see how long it will take you to do everything from the very beginning to end before the actual event starts, even if you are very familiar with the cocktails that need to be made. Don't be like, hey, this usually takes 5 minutes and explanation will be 3 minutes. There always will be questions and things go a lot slower than during rehearsal. So consider that you always will need a few extra minutes. I always start my cocktail experience with a little introduction, show a few cool tricks to get attendees excited. Then we start making cocktails and I make sure to go super slow. Everyone can follow my steps and along the way explain what kind of ingredients could be replaced, teaching some fun techniques, mention facts about spirits or actual cocktail, garnish variations, and of course twists, so like show multiple variations. The event can go 20 to 45 minutes, or maybe sometimes can go as long as 1 hour. And if you have extra time, I know that it's fun to learn a couple of cool, easy bar tricks and maybe show something really impressive at the end. Maybe it's a cocktail presentation or a magic trick, just to make sure it's memorable, visual, something that your guest will remember. But the most important thing in a successful virtual event is to have an incredible time and make sure your guests are really enjoying it from beginning to very end. I noticed how quality of events improving since March, and I believe that this format will stay for a really long time. This is our new reality, and no one can say how long it will take until things will go back to normal. So if you have the skill and ability to teach something that you're really good at, you should start offering virtual events. If this information was helpful, please give me a like and let me know in the comments if I should go into details on how to promote yourself, get clients, how to work with agencies, how much money I make, and more information on virtual events. I'm pretty sure you didn't even know that the Airbnb platform now allows you to be booked for virtual events. Well, you guys let me know if you want to hear more information in a future episode. Thank you guys for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe, and I will see you this week on the main channel, Vlad Slick Bartender, with an epic episode. I'll see you then.